we have Beth Larson, Sandra Bovano with Racket Acceptance and...
Essent Guarantee.
There we go.
Private mortgage insurance.
There we go. So welcome, guys. We're just talking about the real estate, how intertwined with underwriters, because that's what Sandra is. Regional Acceptance Corporation. So today we're gonna break it down how the yin and the yang can be yin and yang, unless that...
Yang or yang?
I think I'm the yang to the yang.
I don't know.
I'm not sure.
I don't know.
We're the yin and yang somewhere.
Okay. So... So, the question is, Sandra, how do you do business with Ms. Beth Larson?
Well, when we have conventional loans, which are very popular now with the market the way it is, a lot of sellers do not even want to take contracts on government loans because they're kind of scared, you know, that they're going to not have enough money to put down. There may be repairs that are required. And let's be real, in this market, sellers want to sell their home as quick and effortlessly as possible. And that's where Beth comes in.
It's, and you know, and we were just talking before the camera turned on, that there's a misconception as well, or a fear that maybe, you know, there's low appraisals with the rising values, that, you know, fast rising values, that an FHA borrower would not have the extra funds to make up the difference,
right,
in that, in the value, and the low appraisal. So there's there's a real impact for the FHA contract out there. So it really is favorable for a conventional buyer right now, for someone that has a pre-approval on a conventional loan. So that's definitely...
Sandra calls you. Mm-hmm. Sandra calls you.
Always with a rush. Always with a rush.
I need help.
The loan's closing today.
So then you're coming in and helping her out.
Yes, she is.
To close the loan.
It's a partnership.
So are we all there?
To get the underwriting, done on the MI side.
On the MI side.
Yes, we underwrite for MI.
This is all you people that want to buy a house. Everybody wants to buy a house.
And we're at the end of the line.
Okay.
So the loan is fully processed. It's underwritten by Sandra already, and we place the MI. So the MI, mortgage insurance, private mortgage insurance for conventional loans, is there to protect the lender. So with anything less than 20% down, private mortgage insurance comes in and protects the lender for risk of default. So that allows the borrower to put less than 20% down.
So you get a good deal out of it. So everybody gets what they need,
yes,
from the deal.
Yes, it allows the transaction,
correct,
to happen. And so, yeah, it.
So then after that, what happens here?
Well, once we basically, so we go ahead and we underwrite the whole loan, we approve it, and then we send it to Beth. And it's usually like, hey, Beth, I send an email like, we're closing in 2 hours. Is there a way you can look at that? And that's where Beth comes in and says, oh, yeah, no problem.
Just for you, Sam.
So, you know, our brokers call, like, hey, we're closing at 12. I don't see the MI. Like, don't worry. I got this.
Okay.
Just having a good relationship with a business partner like Beth makes things so much easier. Because then I know it can be an hour, and she will have her people look at my file and make sure it gets done, and we can close on time. So everybody's happy.
Yeah, these are long-term relationships of, you know, we know we're going to get the package. We know we're going to get everything we need.
Okay.
And
make that money.
And we're gonna
money.
We know it's a long term relationship. We know we're gonna get what we need.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of the day, we're all trying to get the buyer in the house and a closing on time,
correct,
and everything done, because, you know, that's what we're all here for.
Yeah.
We make our broker look good because they're on the front lines. They're there most times at the closing.
Uh-huh.
You know, so they wanna look good to their borrower, they want to look good to their realtor, that's their referral source, so that they can get more business. So it's all just a nice, easy
chain of events. Boom. Yes,
that's a lot of chain of events. We just got broken down what MI is, what the underwriter is. Is everybody keeping up? Just making sure. I don't know.
Yeah. And then the other component, too, on the conventional side, if I can put a little plug in there, too.
That's what we're borrowers.
You know, that we always want to do what's best for the borrowers. You know, everyone in this transaction is trying to, you know, to do what's best for that borrower, individual borrower. You know, and on the conventional private mortgage insurance. One of the best things you can do is educate that borrower for private mortgage insurance that values are increasing, the likelihood of them being able to cancel that mortgage insurance versus an FHA, which is on there for the life of the loan, on conventional, mm-hmm. that they can cancel that. They have the Homeowners Protection Act gives them the ability to request cancellation in a couple of different ways.
So the question is, do a lot of people use this, or is this just an optional thing? So you should get this if you can buy a house, correct?
Yeah, well, yeah, they have the ability. Yeah, okay. they have to if it's less than 20% down. There's no option. They're going to have some sort of mortgage insurance. If there's less than 20% down, they either have government-backed mortgage insurance through FHA or VA, mm-hmm. or private mortgage insurance.
Private.
So, great question.
Well, private is more expensive. Thank you. Private is more expensive, though, correct?
It's based on credit score, okay. Based on LTV. There's six private mortgage insurance companies out there today.
Six.
And they are
sex. We want
these veterans.
We don't
six.
Want
X Club. And that's where the relationship comes in. Because all those rushes.
Yes. I can't build a relationship with six people and expect them to be rushing for me. No, one. That's it. Just one.
Well, you guys are motivational because you guys are just executing. Execute.
Yes, that's where our relationships count.
There we go.
But canceling the mortgage insurance is a great way to educate the borrowers to know what their rights are, mm-hmm. because there are laws to protect them, okay. And so that they know. So no one likes it because it is an extra part of their payment. Mm-hmm. So borrowers do not like it. We understand it. I didn't like it when I had it in mind,
okay.
But there is light at the end of the tunnel. So when you educate them and let them know that. You know, this is not something that has to be in your payment forever.
Yes, correct.
And we have information that, you know, Sandra, that loan officers for your company.
So in the beginning, you should get it, but then later on, maybe.
It can be canceled. Especially when values are increasing, mm-hmm. you know, at the peak, it was 20%. Annual appreciation on your property.
Okay.
You just watch your values. Mm-hmm. You stay in touch with your servicer, because your servicer is the one that has to request the cancellation.
Okay.
But there's light at the end of the tunnel. It's not for the life of the
When you're alive or dead, I mean, I don't know, but we'll see.
Once you pay under, once your equity, increases in your house and you owe a lot less mm-hmm. than what your house is worth, then mm-hmm. you can cancel that. And then it's like instant refinance with no cost because you say that mortgage insurance comes right off and your payment reduces for no reason, for nothing.
And then you do the paperwork on that, right? You're the boss on that.
No. You call whoever you're making your payments to.
Gotcha.
You have to communicate with them.
Okay. Because I'm a rent. Yeah. All right.
What?
I'm ashamed of that.
What?
I'm not ready to buy
what?
That.
What?
Who's not ready?
I'm going to throw it out there. I'm not ready to stop. Anyway.
Yeah.
So this is all information for me too, everybody.
That's right.
Okay, this is all you.
What?
I was excited about this. This is my Underwriters, regional acceptance, regional, and we're going regional, we're going Coastal Connect. It's a bunch of stuff going on here.
But yeah. I think what people need to know, though,
okay.
our brokers out there, what they need to know is that, not only are we building good relationships with them and our loyalty to them, is we have loyalty to our business partners as well. So we can all work together as a nice, tight-knit family, so to speak.
Yeah.
That's why we're a boutique lender, as we call ourselves, because we deal with only a certain number of people. We don't
boutique.
Boutique.
No, boutique.
And it's important to know your it's a great but it's important to know that you have all these resources through your boutique lender. Because they can help you provide those cancellation information, all those things. Because if you have a happy borrower, they get to closing on time, they're happy. What do? They refer.
Mm-hmm.
They come back. Because that's a problem in our
mm-hmm.
industry.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't happen as often as it should.
Right.
So.
How's the industry looking now? I may ask. Is it good? Is it declining? Is it declining? Is it still doing good? So, Beth, how is the industry looking?
It's looking great. It has been fabulous.
Yeah. Is it still streaming? Is it still going up? I mean, I'm not in the industry, so I want to know.
Yeah.
I want to know firsthand the people that are in the game instead of seeing it in CNN or whatever. You know? Yeah. You know?
It's still busy.
Still busy?
It's still busy.
Still busy. Still busy. All right.
I mean, you know, we go through little peaks of, you know, interest rates being a little, a little crazy, but, you know, it's all depending on the market.
Okay.
And, you know.
So what do you tell people out there right now that want to buy a house? Is it a good time, a bad time, should they all, let's be honest with people.
It is always a good time to buy a house.
Ooh. It is. I mean, always a good time to be a homeowner. Yes.
Yes. With confidence. Yes. Always a good time.
Always. Yes. It's always a good time to close your loan with RAC.
Yeah, there you go. Yes.
And your conventional loan with RAC, so.
Yes.
Best to do the mortgage.
Welcome to the mortgage.
Yes.
Well, once again, thank you.
Always a great investment.
Yes.
To buy a home.
It is.
It is.
Liquidation. That might be another subject. Liquidation.
That could be for the next time.
For the next
time. I don't want to give up.
There's always going to be a next.
They're always
going to be in again.
Residentially
said. Tune in again. Yeah.
Well, thank you again.
I don't know how long have you been in the industry. So.
50 years. You closed last 50 years. 50
years. At least 50 years. It feels like 100 some days.
Yeah. It's 30, depends on the day. It's 39 for me. Yeah. So we've seen a lot of changes.
Well, yes, for that one, sure.
Anyway,
yeah.
So we've got a lot of experience,
seen
a lot of things.
And shows with information that you're giving us right now, I appreciate that. That's really nice.
Because
once again, I'm a renter.
Yeah,
there's a lot of people renting that want to buy that should contact you.
Right, there's brokers that want a good lender. A good lender that can provide.
And a one good MI.
Yeah, quick closings. That's what they want, right? Brokers want quick closings. They need to make their money. They need to get their borrower at home.
Mm-hmm.
And why not work with the dream team right here?
Oh!
Wow!
Dream team, everyone!
That's right,
that's
here.
Awesome.
That was a, But once again, thank you for joining us at Coastal Connection, Embrace the Power. Beth Larson, MI Specialist, Sandra Bobano, Underwriter Specialist for Regional, non-stop, Residential Acceptance.
Get it right.
But thank you for showing us the way of buying a home. Let's sit down a little more, maybe it's gonna be part three or four. I mean, if this might lead to the real estate, you know.
Keep it going.
But as we say, close to the connection, we keep it rolling.